Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to talk about calculation groups as they relate to implicit versus explicit measures. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. Okay, I've had a couple of people ask me about this and they're like, Patrick, my matrix isn't working anymore once I added the calculation group. Why not? And I go, well, there's a difference. You're using implicit measures. Why aren't you using explicit measures? And they go, what does that have to do with calculation groups? Since that question was asked a couple of times, I decided to do a video on it. All right, so you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So you've designed this nice, tidy model and you're using these implicit measures in your matrix and you decide, hey, I want to do some time intelligence, like month to date, year to date, quarter to date, same period last year. So instead of creating an explicit measure for each one of these, you go, I'm gonna create a calculation group and continue to use my implicit measures. Will that work? Well, I'll tell you this, go read the documentation. Nah, you don't have to read it. I'm gonna talk about it in this video. All right, back to my laptop. Let's say you do this. You go to external tools, you pop open tablet editor, either the open source version or the paid version. I just so happen to be using the paid version. You right click on tables and you create a calculation group. I've already created my time intelligence calculation group, added a couple of items to it, month to date, quarter to date, year to date, and same period last year. The one thing that all these have in common is that I'm using selected measure, because you got to use selected measure when you create your calculation group. Then you head back over to your model. And if you're like me, I pay attention to my model really closely because you guys know I'm kind of model obsessed. Anyway, I noticed that these sigma symbols are gone, right? My summation symbols are gone. What it means is if I say I'm gonna check this, it adds it to the rows and now it expands and collapses it. It makes it part of the rows. So I say, well, that's not right. I'm gonna drag it over to my values. But it doesn't let me. I go, oh, maybe that's just order quantity. So I'll check the sales amount. And that one doesn't work either. And at this point, you're like, why is that not working? Well, what happens under the covers is when you create a calculation group, the tablet editor automatically discourages implicit measures. There's a property on your model called discourage implicit measures, and it's automatically set to true. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So if we head over to tablet editor, you'll see that once I create my calculation group, if I click on my model and I go to my properties window, if the property window isn't there, just right click on it and go to properties and it'll open up. And what I like to do is sort it alphabetically. So just click this to sort alphabetically. You can put them in groups and go search for that property or just go alphabetical and then go to the D section and you'll see discourage implicit measures. It's set to true. If I change it to false, I should get a nice little warning. Property value is not valid. If we expand out details, it tells you the property must be set to true when the model contains a calculation group. So you can't switch it. You can't toggle it back. It has to be set to true because when you use calculation groups, you cannot use implicit measure because the selected measure function is expecting an explicit measure. So to fix this, after you create your calculation group, it's actually really simple. You go over to your model, you create an explicit measure. Now, if I drop this in the values, it accepts it. If I check the box, it drops it in the value section. If I choose quarter to date, you'll see after each quarter, the value will reset and begin to sum up again. If I choose same period last year, it'll take a look back to the same month for that prior year. And if I choose year to date, it'll scroll it all the way out. All right. So what do you guys think? Have you solved this a different way? I sure love to know if you came up with a different solution. Have you run into this problem before? Again, I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in a Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.